Hello dear friends, and this is your friend Dr. Suresh NV here. Yesterday on my channel, one of my viewer asked me to make a video on reverse S curvature in class 2 cavity preparation. I remember my days of being a student, and when I read the pseudo one, I never used to understand what exactly is this reverse S curvature. And the only line which is given in the book is, it says, it is given in the buccal side because the lingual embrasure is very large. So many of the time the students are really confused, because this is one of the favorite question for the examiners, especially in the second BDS and when you are in a final year. So over a period of time I have understood this thing, and I hope that in today's video I will try to make it as simple as possible. And trust me that this is by far the most simple explanation by which you can understand about the reverse S curve. Now, before understanding reverse S curve, we'll have to know about the contact, because when you prepare the reverse S curve in class 2, it mostly depends on the contacts. And reverse S curve is not related to the contact which is there from occlusal to the cervical area. It is more related to how the contact is situated in the buccolingual direction, and this is only seen especially in the posteriors rather than in any anteriors because of this configuration of the contact. If you see the image of the contact area, and specifically maxillary second premolar and the maxillary first molar, the contact here is different than the contact which you may find in mandibulars. But before understanding that, you have to understand these two terminologies. Of course, we all know the contact is the area where the two teeth come in closest approach. And you can see in this image, this is the area where there is a contact between these two teeth. But the area which is created, this is the triangular area which is created on both, the actually called as the embrasures. So you have four embrasures, that is the buccal, lingual, occlusal and the gingival embrasures. The class 2 cavity preparation considers both the contact, that is occluso gingival and buccolingual. I will try to make another video on class 2, probably with a extracted teeth, so that you can understand it better. But for today's lecture, I hope that you understood these two terminologies, that is contact and the embrasure. When you see the mandibular, the contact is generally situated in the center. So let us go back to this image. You can see that the contact, the lingual embrasure here, or you can call it as a palatal embrasure since it is maxillary. This is wide, this is small, indicating that the buccal contact, is situated more buccally. Whereas in mandibular teeth, you can see the embrasures on both the side is equal, indicating that the contact is situated more often into the center. So my request to the students is, during the video, if you have, please post it to the comment section, or you can always rewrite it into the comment section when the stream replays after it's recorded. And a gentle reminder to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any new videos. Now your teacher always tells you in class 2 that you have to break the contact, and many students don't understand you have to break the contact. You know, why is it so important? So let us try to understand the concept of breaking the contact by looking at this image. So this is a mandibular, premolar and molar contact which is situated into the center, and this is the extent. The red bars indicate the extent of the contact. So the contact starts here and it extends till here. So the wall of proximal box should be beyond the area of this contact. So when you do this, and when you finally break the proximal wall, you can see that there is a space which is created. So this image shows that the contact is no longer present and there is a gap which is created here. This gap is called as clearance, which is very important, because if the margin is beyond this contact, that means the margin will be available for proper finishing and polishing, and even the patient brush can reach there and he can maintain it in a proper way. Of course, there are situations where you may not break the contact, and we will try to cover it in class to cavity preparation video. Now coming to the today's important topic, that is reverse S curve. Let us understand it in the maxillary, because we find it mostly into the maxillary molar, and that is more commonly given in the first molar because of a peculiar presence of the contact, as mentioned earlier, that in maxillary molars the contact is situated more buccally, as seen in this picture. So this is the area of the contact. It starts from here to here, and all of us know how we prepare the occlusal step and proximal box, and when you see the outline occlusally, you can do a class 2 occlusal outline in this way. So you started from here, you started from here, and you came to this curvature. This is where your the primary groove will straighten up, and I can obviously go from this area to the proximal side. I start straight from here and I can go straight here. So I have at the end of the removal of the proximal box, my cavity margin would be definitely beyond the contact, giving me a good amount of clearance. But if you do that, you will realize that at the end of the cavity preparation, you will have a very less amount of cusp on the buccal side. So the strength of this cusp would be really weak compared to the size of the cusp which is remaining on the palatal side. And we all know that the mesiopalatal cusp in maxillary molar is the largest, but the mesiobuccal is the second largest one. But if you directly start from here and start breaking the contact, then the amount of cusp what will remain here will be very less, which is not good for the strength of the tooth. So what will we do? Rather than going straight, I would curve from this area, go more towards the palatal side, and then from the isthmus area I will try to diverge, and ultimately the proximal buccal wall would be definitely beyond the buccal contact area. On the palatal side, you can always go straight and wherever the contact is ending so that you get the clearance. Now if you see the amount of cusp what is remaining, it will be definitely more than the original configuration which we tried to get when you directly cut straight from the curvature. So if you see the two images, in this image we are directly taking the cavity from this end to breaking the contact, but the cusp will be less. But if you go across the cusp and then diverge it, you will still end up breaking the contact and you will get a good amount of cusp. So this configuration is called as reverse S curvature, which allows you to save the cusp structure and also helps you to break the contact. So you have to break the contact in class 2, but now you can save the cusp and break the contact, so you can take the advantage. Another one thing you can see in this picture is the palatal wall is shifted more towards the palatal side when you do a reverse S curvature. Now you might say that is bad for the palatal cusp, but that doesn't make any difference because the size of the palatal cusp is very large. So even though to compensate the curvature, if you push your palatal wall more towards the palatal side, it is not going to weaken the tooth structure in this situation. Now where do the students really do make mistakes? They try to, and this is a very common mistake which I had when in my mind when I was a student, and I did it for many, you know, cavity preparation, and then my teacher explained me that this is not the right way to go ahead with this, because when we remember S curve, we imagine the curvature exactly as S. So you can see this end of S, and we try to do it in the similar way, in the similar way in a cavity preparation. So if you see that if you do an exactly S shape, that you will have this thin enamel wall which will remain after you do a class 2 cavity preparation, and this will break, this will break. So to prevent that, we do it in a different configuration, and this is very important, because if you have seen my earlier video of fundamentals of cavity preparation, it clearly says that KO surface margin should be 90 degree for amalgam, whether it is occlusal or whether it is the buccal wall which is meeting the proximal box. So in this image, as you can see, that this the red marking indicates the angle between the external wall and the proximal buccal wall. So this junction should be 90 degree, because that gives you a nice trend to the walls of the amalgam restoration. Now this is exactly why the word reverse is mentioned into the S curvature. If you follow the exactly S, then of course you will end up leaving the slight amount of enamel. But if you take it more towards the outside, then you get a reverse S curve. So, and that is exactly explains the terminology. Now your teacher will definitely ask you why we don't give reverse S curve in mandibular teeth. Frankly speaking, reverse curvature can be given in any teeth, but it all depends on the contact configuration. So in mandibular area, you know that the contact is more situated into the center, and even if you go straight or even if you go one side or the other side, the amount of cusp what remains on both the side may not be, there may not be too much of a difference. So our cavity preparation in mandibular class 2 is generally straight, and then you diverge toward the end to get break the contact, but rest of the cavity will be straight without any curvature. But there are situations where your premolar may be slightly buccally situated. In that situation, you may have to give a reverse curvature in mandibular teeth also. If you see the junction between the maxillary first molar and second molar, then the contact is not as buccally situated as the junction between maxillary first molar and maxillary second premolar. So the reverse curvature in general is very prominent in maxillary first molar because of this configuration of buccally situated contact point. So I hope this explains the contact point, the reverse S curvature in a very simple way. If you still have any doubt, please post into the comment section. And if you want me to make few more videos, you are always welcome to suggest into the comment section, and I will try to make a video as soon as possible. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I hope that you have a great day, and because of the COVID situation, please take care of your health and your family. See you soon in my next video. Bye for now.